Baby pink is my favorite color.
I may or may not know Cookie Monster.
I have a dog named Bono.
I don't have a dog, but I'm a plant daddy.
I was born in Taiwan.
I am definitely a Libra. Ready,
1, 2, 3. Watch the assignment.
The assignment.
I'm Melissa King, and I'm a chef, entrepreneur, and activist in San Francisco.
I'm Phoenix, and I'm a psychology student and an actor, and I'm from a lot of places.
Hi, sit down.
So nice to meet you.
Me too. Welcome to San Francisco.
Thank you. Yeah, do you live here?
Yeah, I've been here for about 15 years now, and I grew up in LA, specifically the San Gabriel Valley.
Oh.
Which is like pretty Asian populated.
Yeah.
It's a good place, a lot of good food down there.
I grew up in China. I actually also got a lot of that. I'm half Chinese, but most of the family that I've grown up with and that I've, you know, eaten food with has been Italian.
I love that because I'm Chinese.
Yeah.
But my cooking style is sort of French-Italian, but I love the flavor combinations of Italian and Chinese specifically.
Really?
Because you have things like noodles,
yeah,
and you have pasta, and then you have dumplings, and you have raviolis.
Yeah.
And there's so much commonality and common ground between, yeah, these type of cultures and the cuisines that you probably grew up on.
Yeah.
Well, we're gonna cook. How's your cooking?
Oh, right. So definitely not my strong suit.
Have you made dumplings before?
I grew up kind of like helping my ayi like squeeze the...
Like make the little pleats?
Yeah, make the little pleats and stuff. And I like watched her make it a lot, but most of the time, no. Most of the time I was too young or too clumsy, really.
Well, I feel like that's where we start though. At least for me, when, yeah, I was a kid, there'd be a big pile of filling in the middle of the table and all the
just
cousins, everybody
piece,
would come, yeah, around and just, you know, start
mine were
crimping.
Always overstuffed, though,
yeah. They're
so,
always like
stuff
just
coming out,
wonky looking, yeah, and at the end of the day, it doesn't matter. It's,
yeah,
like really about the beauty of doing it together and the sense of community.
Yeah.
Anyways, you ready to go shopping?
Yeah, let's
head
go
to the market. Whoa, definitely need some ginger, scallions, Napa cabbage. Maybe grab some of that cilantro. This was my childhood right here, standing in front of live seafood.
I used to go out to the ocean with my ayi and get,
really,
snails. My mom is not Chinese, and she didn't speak a lot of Chinese, so it was,
yeah,
all of my like Chinese exposure, I feel like, was through my ayi.
You had a way more amazing childhood than I did.
It was
so fun. We need some snacks for the middle of prep time, you know, just to kind of shrimp chips.
This,
oh,
stuff.
Oh, yeah.
Right here.
Japanese, yes, rice crackers.
This is what I'm talking,
oh,
about.
I haven't had this since I was a kid.
These are so good.
Okay, let's try those.
Yep,
all right, plenty of snacks to hold us over. We're going to make pork and salted cabbage dumplings. I think we should start on the filling.
Okay.
This filling's gonna have ground pork, salted cabbage.
Right.
Ginger scallions, that's like a pretty traditional Chinese dumpling that I grew up on.
Yeah.
I don't know if you had,
same,
it that way.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay, so let's take this thing down.
How do you cut a cabbage that big?
Right?
Wow.
Honestly, that's plenty.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, that's great. Beautiful job. All right, so jump in there. I always learned from my grandma and my mom that you want to salt the cabbage. What that does is it really extracts some of the moisture out of there. When there's too much moisture, your filling will be too wet. Yeah, it's not gonna hold very well inside,
yeah,
the dumpling.
Yeah, I think I've done that once before for like cucumber salad.
Exactly.
Yeah.
So I'll cut through these scallions. I use all of it. I don't like to waste anything. I feel like the whole point of dumplings is to use whatever you have in the fridge. Grab me the ground pork from the,
yeah,
fridge in there.
Okay.
Did you ever learn to peel ginger with a spoon?
No.
Yeah, this is a fun little technique that I learned from my grandma and my mom. Take a spoon and scrape it, and it'll just peel away without taking away too much of the flesh. Did you ever cook with your mom growing up?
She used to say that I could burn water, I think.
Oh, no.
She was like, she's just not one of those people that can cook.
So I like to grate the ginger right into the bowl.
Look at me now, Mom.
All right, great job. White pepper.
Ooh.
Sprinkle that in. That's soy. Sesame oil. Chinese rice wine. That egg white. My mom always taught me to put a pinch of the cornstarch.
Oh.
And then let's
the
do
secrets.
A couple pinches of salt. And then that salted cabbage,
oh my God, it looks so
kinda like
different.
Wilts down, yeah, and all that liquid comes out and it's nice and dry. But mix that all together for us. Yeah, that's what real chefs
this
do.
This brings me back memories.
And yeah, have our dumpling dough. It's literally just flour and water. So what kind of Chinese and Italian dishes did you have growing up?
My aunt used to make this like eggplant meat patty. But yeah, she was like a really good cook and she would always make us
Sounds like it.
Random little things and haven't been able to replicate it ever since, you know?
That's always the hard part is like my grandma had a zong recipe. Mm-hmm. Like it was like the sticky rice with that's the wrapped in the lotus leaf.
Yeah.
And no one in our family knew how to make that. And I had to figure
it out
by like going on the internet and figuring out how to fold it and chop chop.
It's little pillows.
Yeah, just little pillows.
They look like gnocchi.
Exactly. This is a little cornstarch that I've dusted it with.
Okay.
Our little dumpling rolling pin passed down from my great grandmother.
Really?
Totally messing with you. No. We're gonna smash this down into a circle and try to get it as thin as you can without breaking the skin, but leave enough space to do the crimps.
So what's it like being a queer chef?
I actually feel extremely grateful for being a queer chef because I do find my community of chefs tends to be quite accepting.
Yeah.
You know, there are moments where it can be tough. It could be tough enough to just be a woman in the kitchen. Yeah, it's incredible now to see that there's just a lot more Asian chefs, queer chefs that are just doing amazing things and putting themselves out there.
It's crazy how much it can change your idea of like what's possible when you see someone else doing it.
Yeah, and Phoenix, how about you? How have you found your queer community?
You know, growing up as a bisexual person, it's a little easy to be like, oh, I'm gonna ignore that side of myself and just be the person that people want me to be. If I'm hiding that part of myself, then it's really easy to hide other parts of myself.
Exactly. Here, you can take this one.
All right.
I start with a little bit because a little can go a long way.
Is that too much?
No, that's great. Dip your finger in and kind of wet the edges. Fold it into like a half moon, but then you're going to crimp the edges while you're doing that.
Oh.
All right, we're gonna pan sear these dumplings over here. Just a little bit of flour and water. A little lid on. A lot of that liquid's going to evaporate.
Right.
And that flour will get left over and it'll create a nice skin.
Mm.
Well, we'll just let that hang out. Let's go eat some snacks.
Yeah, these were my favorite candies growing up.
Mmm, the white rabbit. Mm-hmm. Want a shrimp chip?
Yes.
Ooh. Okay, there we go. Plate these up over here. Okay, let's give this a go. That's not bad. So they get crispy. All right.
Wow.
Those are our dumplings.
It makes it look super fancy.
You hungry?
Yes.
After you.
Okay. I will take this one. Mmm.
How are we doing?
I'm so good.
Mm. Look at what we made today.
That's awesome.
I'm really proud of us. How are you feeling?
Honestly, can't believe we did that. I feel like in my head as a kid, the memories made it seem a lot more complicated.
Yeah.
But I really feel like I can go home and make some dumplings.
Do you think you'd make these for your friends?
Yeah.
Like, it's a bit of work, but it all comes together.
Yeah.
And I think we did a really fantastic job today.
Honestly, like, I did learn a lot and I feel like really inspired being able to talk to you about like how you got to where you are, and it makes me feel a lot better about where I am too, and I feel a lot more confident from this experience.
Thank you.
Yeah.
That's why I love doing what I do.
I'm so glad to be a recipient of that, then. Thank you.
Watch the assignment.